separated from the rest of Oman by the United Arab Emirates is the northernmost part of the Sultanate. Due to its geographical position and mountainous terrain, it was isolated from the rest of Oman and the region developed at its own pace. Graded roads cut across the mountains have now made it more accessible. The grandeur of Musandam can best be explored by sea. Musandam Peninsula has an abundance of sheltered fjords, some only connected to the mainland by narrow cliffs. Fjords are cores created by fragment rock stretching claw-like into the sea, and massive overshadowing cliffs towering above are magnificently reflected in the water below. The coast juts into the Strait of Hormuz and extends some 600 kilometers. These spectacular fjords have given the area the second name, the Norway of Arabia. The Strait of Hormuz is only 60 kilometers wide and doesn't exceed 60 meters depth, and is of the strategic importance of Oman, as 90% of all the Gulf's oil trade passes through this area. The total population of Musandam is approximately 20,000, and the capital, Khasab, has 18,000 inhabitants. Diba, on the east coast of Musandam, has a population of approximately 5,500. The peninsula begins with Tibat, on the west coast in the Arabian Gulf of Damba, on the east coast in the Gulf of Oman. This coastal zone, along with many offshore islands, offers a unique contact with nature. Small villages nestle along the tortuous shoreline, most of them only accessible by sea, like Lima and Tumsa. Its rugged mountains rise up over 2,000 meters above sea level. In Arabic, it's known as the Ras Musandam. The peninsula is mainly inhabited by the Shihu, who are fishermen and herdsmen and are probably descended from the original inhabitants of northern Oman. Fishing is the peninsula's main industry, with packing plants at Al Khasab and Baya. Transportation is mostly by sea, since no roads can cross the forbidden terrain.
First of all, I would like to represent our captain, Mr. Mohammed, and our helper boy, Mr. Habib, and myself. My name is Nasser, and your don, current visitor. It's a hard day to work. I mean, we need about 4 hours to do this excursion. We are now about 500 kilometers away from Moscow, and the name of this village is Khasab. It's considered as the capital of Musandam. As you know, Oman is divided into 11 governorates, and it has only 20,000 inhabitants. Khasab means the fertility. So right now, program will first try to find dolphins. We have about 17 to 100 dolphins at this area. It has about 17 kilometers long and is composed today of 5 villages with about 300 inhabitants. So we need about 20 minutes to be there. So our sand festival will try to find dolphins. Then after it will be the first fishing village. The name of this village is Hana. Included in price, we have also filled water, some drinks. Yeah? And we have also toilets. They are included also in our price. The toilets are behind us, behind the captain. Yeah, toilets behind the captain. Okay? Thank you. Ich glaube, wir haben abgeholt, oder? So, von hier aus werden wir Richtung den Fjord fahren, den Hoosier Schatz genannt ist. So, hat insgesamt 17 Kilometer lang. You want to change our program? You go to Iran if you want. We need about 2 hours to be there. Diese Straße And das hat heute 64 Kilometer lang und es war 40 Kilometer breit. Also we can find nothing from this area. The Strait of Hormuz, which is situated northly from Musandam, it's about 35 kilometers by way from here. Today the capital of Musandam. It's like a peninsula which is situated between Oman and the UAE. It has today about 1,800 square kilometers with only 30,000 inhabitants. I went there, waiting a minute, coming here. What is shot? On? Yeah, lift the block. Now we need about 5 minutes to arrive. And if you admire, especially its confidence. I said the second name is the Arab of Norway. You come yes on? The doctor, the sergeant of it, that's Jordan, as to the Arabian Norwegian. Transhuman, the Honorshan, he says, Greek is. So I said, first we'll try to find what is in Iraq. We asked Zutman, Delphina.
Thank you.
I said to his father, he tells about 30 inhabitants, and you can see there is no access to the land. That's why normally every family should have a private speedboat, especially to take their kids to Khasab, in which they stay in Khasab. From Saturday to Wednesday, they study there at Khasab. So now, education in Oman is obliging. Since 1972, 1973, today about 92% of the kids go to school. So the name I said, the name of this village is Tana, and it comes from the Arab word Al-Qina, and it means the occupant mosque. Maybe you can see the mosque on that mountain. Yeah, you can see the nose, the hair, and the mouth of this mosque. Yeah? But maybe you can see on top from here, there's Arab houses facing back to the 16th part of the we will try again to find the doctor. Yes, that's a hot needle, needle cleaner, yeah? Das ist der einzige, also Dorf, der nicht im Wasser liegt. Telegraph Island, just in front of you, the famous island of the fjord. As you know, the bridge, and after the messages were sent in from Iran. Now you will have your possibility to swim. And the place is strictly forbidden to go to the island. You'll have your time only to swim. So you'll have now your stop, your swimming stop. I suppose now the water has about 23 degrees.
Okay, in you go, darling.
Hey, Robert.
Okay. We are a dhow, pardon. Want them all you want? Now you are right. We have shot the road, right? The winner is in the best of the rest of the dragon. So I said we have about the 2-100. Something. We have two, we have black and the...
Você não pode pôr a mão, ele pode dar uma cabeçada.
Você abraçou a Ine e ela te fez alguma coisa?
So now you're left, so you have other ones.
Olha aqui nadando, hein? Olha aí do nosso lado, rápido, olha aqui. Tá vendo, Kiara?
Pode ficar jogando em cima da mulher.
Eu quero.
Calma aí que
eu
vou tirar a foto.
So this is the capital of the fjord. The name is Ashab. Maybe it has the Persian origin, and it's been as the eyes. It is the largest village. That's why it is today considered as the capital, yeah? And it is also the oldest village of the area. You can see from here that largest white building. It's the mosque. As you know, the mosque is composed of a minaret and the praying room, but it has no minaret. Today, the Omani people, most of them, they are Ibarites. They represent about 65%. We find them also in other Islamic countries, but they represent only 1% in all the Islamic countries. We can find them, especially in Algeria and also in Tunisia. The second group, they are the Sunnis, so with about 27%. And the third group, they are the Shiites, with about 8%. Until now, they live so in peace. Those are three Islam groups, yeah? Islam is the official religion of Oman. I think they did well their job, yeah? Thank you. Best of luck. Then I would like to thank you especially for your friendly there for the opportunity. And I hope you have enjoyed our tour, our excursion. To the famous island, to the photograph island, that we saw dolphins, yeah? And at the end, it was the capital of the fishing village of Al-Sham.
Direction and slight seas. The minimum temperature tonight will be 21 degrees Celsius, that's 70 degrees Fahrenheit. The forecast for Muscat tomorrow calls for another beautiful sunny day with a high of 26 degrees, that's 79 degrees Fahrenheit. So after we have let go our lines, we will turn it on in the port head and steam out. Tonight we're going to do a little differently. We're going to go a bit closer to the coast and go the inshore traffic lines across the top of the peninsula here. So at least for a little while it's still daylight, you will be able to enjoy the beautiful sight of this part of Oman. So once again, we'll go back aboard and do enjoy your cruise vacation.